Which, I mean, the clothes that were going to matches.
Time, yeah.
There was clothes going to matches that time.
Yeah.
You wouldn't get them seen again, no. Mm-hmm. You know.
The year after we played again. We won the
Western 61.
We did, yeah.
And you played Kilmallock in the semi final.
In Drum.
And like that again, it was. Mike Crumman scored, he was full forward. And Mike Doody was in the corner. And Ned Cain was on that team, wasn't he? Ned Cain from Monaghan.
Was Ned on it?
He was on that 61 team, I'd say. And Mike Crumman scored four goals out there. Would you believe it? Scored four goals. And the man that he was marking was the cornerback for Kilmallock. They took him off and put him down corner forward. And he went down and scored three goals around the corner.
But the same man that was on in that team, if I can remember, was Bernie Savage.
He was Bernie Savage.
But he was the danger man, and he, towards the end of it, actually to see the beaters. Towards the end of it,
Bernie
Savage.
Yes.
Yeah.
And no, it was a draw that day.
Was it a draw?
Yeah.
We went into the Gaelic grounds then
for the replay.
And we were annihilated.
And annihilated in the
Gaelic
grounds.
Too big, the pitch was too big, never saw the ball.
But you sort of beat Kilmallock, and like that again, they went down to win an easy county as well. And so Tipperary's won an easy county after beating us. They won their county final by quickest score as well, but you're asked to look again.
There was a supporter for Newcastle that time, and he was shouting. His son was playing, and there was a Kilmallock man putting his hand up. He constantly putting his hand up for the war, and he sort of take it from the wrist. But Kilmallock had a very strong team. There was a lot of county holders on it as well.
62, then you were going for three in a row in 62.
That's right, that was the big one, yeah.
You went for three in a row, it was a great thing, and Knockaderry beat you in the final, and you were expected to beat Knockaderry.
Oh, we were sure, they were hot favourites. As a matter of fact, we were told after there was a nice bit of money on us.
Yeah.
To win it, and we went down. We should have beaten them, but just a collapse, complete collapse.
Yeah, and you won the minor football that year then?
Then we had nothing else to play for, as you know, at that time. It was a knockout, you were gone earlier. Yeah. So we concentrated on the football,
right.
And they were to play Abbey Field in the final. Mm-hmm. I don't know how we got to the final. We beat Drum, I think, in the way, but we got to the final, and it was held in Newcastle. And Abbey Field came down certainties,
right.
And we beat Abbey Field. It was a good, it was the biggest shock.
But there was great rivalry at that time between Abbey Field and Newcastle. Terrible rivalry, I remember. I mean, the 21, had 21 hadn't started at that time. Roughly. It was after that the 21 started. But I remember Newcastle played a great, they played a great Abbey Field team below in Rackheel. A great Abbey Field team. And you had like that, you had young Kevin.
O'Donnell.
Kevin O'Donnell and Brendan, and they were on that minor team. I'm not sure it was Paul Dummert on that team as well. But they played a great Abbey Field team behind the thing. Great Abbey Field team. That was in 65, I'd say.
The evening we played Abbey Field in the football. And but I remember there was an umpire, I think he was from IT, you might never remember. But Abbey Field got a goal at the start, and they shouldn't have got it. It was completely and utterly. But young Parr anyway, he said he'd make up for it later on, and he did make up for it.
That was human nature. It's easy for a fellow to make a mistake.
Yeah.
Like the ball might be off the line, he put up the flag. And like that. But in most cases, they did try to make up for it.
They did.
It's not always possible to do it.
That's right.
But they did. But genuinely, if they made a genuine mistake, they did try to make up for it. The same with referees, like that. If he gave a free against you and he knew, like, on the bottom one, he blew the whistle. But if he knew it was wrong,
he kind of
give you the benefit of the doubt after when you knew it was a free against you, you know.
There was one man there, he was the star on that team, you know, he was a complete footballer. There was Noel O'Connor.
Oh, no.
He was a gifted, even hurling in football.
Noel made the limit, minor hurling team too that year. Or the year
he did.
That year. It might have been 61, was it?
I saw him playing above against.
He played Cork.
And he was above an Innes another day. I think was it against Clare or something. We went up to see him playing.
Yeah, and like the thing about it, like the Newcastle men had to be twice as good as any other to get on the minor team.
You was going for a trial, sure, you know, yeah. We'd go up to Brough for a trial, and it was kind of going over, but you knew you were only getting want to get about 10 minutes and of a run, and that's
more,
it.
And more than likely, then if you were playing half-back, you were putting Conor Fowler.
That's right, yeah.
Or if you were Conor Fowler, they might put you in a half-back. That was you gone forever.
Like, oh, you were gone, you were only going over. And there's a possibility you might even get on for the trial over.
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
You know
right.
what I mean? But yeah. I suppose we thought it was an achievement
at the time to get
over and get a trial, you know. To, but I'm not too sure who he is. Yeah. Head up to his face, he was shy.
Yeah. That was Donnie Harrington. Yeah. He lived here in the park.
His father was a guard, was he?
No, his father was the bus conductor.
Oh, the bus conductor.
Up the bus to Cork. And there was Tony Kane,
John Delane,
John DeBarber,
Billy Lennon,
Ray McGuire,
Moss Brewer. And we think that's Ted McGrath.
Yeah.
Billy Murphy.
Yeah, died a young boy.
Yeah, Ned Keane. Noel O'Connor, David Kennedy, and myself, Dylan
McGuire. There'd be a share missing from that time.
There would be, yeah. Because photographs that time were very scarce.
I met my crewman there only a couple of weeks ago. We were up to the main walking. We walk every day, as you know yourself. Mm. And Mike was saying, I had no interest in Hullin, says Mike. Only that we were pals together at the time. He said, and you said to me, come up to the field. And we went up to the field. And before they knew it, the team was announced. And he was playing his first match in the skating. And himself, Noel Baker and Rackard. They scored 12 goals against the Skane in the first round, but that was the opposition. Like the opposition wasn't there. If we had met Drumcolour or Fiona in the first round, we'd have been down that sort of it. But he gave an incentive to keep going, like, you know.
But that time as well, you know, if you were playing the team, everybody nearly went for a jersey when the bag came.
He did, yeah.
And next thing, you might see, then the team would be called out. You might have a jersey. Yeah. Take that off and give it to what.
Because they'd be torn jerseys.
Torn
jerseys. Yeah. And if anyone had a torn jersey, and he would say, swap jersey with him.
That's right, yeah. Yeah,
with training brooders. The new field started in 1960. We did hold in 1960 the new field, because why I remember that so well was after that Father Paddy Doody went away to the priesthood. Right? And he was made a presentation above in the new field. And he was made a presentation of, I think it was a Bible. Now I might be 100% wrong, but I think it was a Bible. And how I remember it so well, Joe Dowling, or Dowling, we said Dowling, from Dwally was the captain, and Joe wasn't there. And I was the vice captain at the time, so it was I made a presentation, above in At the gate you come into the field, not the gate, come into the, actually into the field, right at that gate, that's where the presentation was made to him, in 1960. But then, do you remember the carnivals?
That's right, yeah.
The carnivals that time, you know, and all the players were involved in something, do you know what I mean? You were either involved with the chairpins, the boats.
That's right, yeah. You were, the bumpers.
The bumpers, because... the carnival crowd had their man with the purse, with the bag. But you being the GA representative, you counted the number of chairs on the thing, and you had correspond, it was sixpence or whatever it was ago, we have 30 chairs. All right, that's 6 pence a head, that's 15 euro. And you would say, your man would say, we have only 24 chairs, and I'd say, we have 30 chairs. He was trying to make, you know, which was, he had his book and you had your book. And then after that, you see, you went into Nash's house, Paddy Carroll Nash's house. And that's where the accounts would be made up after, the money would be counted and all that. And then, of course, after that, then we had our passes. We had our passes for the dance then. We were all, you know, that age.
But it was a great fundraising, the team, you know, the teams, you know.
Oh, it was.
The players were mad to get involved that
time. They were all involved that time, like,
everybody be looking forward to the carnival.
They would, they were all involved.
And the crowds come into the town, didn't you? Yeah. It was Saturday or Sunday night, you know, big crowds in.
Okay.
Yeah. And the tournament would be on, maybe, there might be a tournament.
Oh, there'll always be a tournament.
And Newcastle, the bigger, you know, the junior hurlers that time. Oh, yeah. But they weren't seen at junior.
Junior,
and you'd have the big ones coming in, where you used to draw the big crowds, were Fiona and... Newcastle, isn't that right, Tim?
Yeah, yeah.
Fiona in Newcastle that time, it was, you'd already well. Yeah. And you had Jack and Jim Quaid and you had...
And just about getting good at that time with Patrick Swill.
Patrick Swill,
they were,
yeah.
No, they were later on probably. They were just getting going, Rakeel. Of course, Rakeel had a good old following as well.
But Fiona with the...
And Academy.
They had. But it was Fiona with the big ones. Oh, you know what I mean? The Royal Villery was there.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
You know,
yeah,
yeah. Jim with Glory Jack and that.
Glory Jack.
Carmelback. But it was great to fundraise in that time, you know.
Oh, yeah, the carnival was great.
It was great, you know. But it's like everything else.
That, you were nearly dancing nearly every second night, didn't you know? Mm-hmm. And if you were involved with one of the bumpers or the chair planes or something like that, after that, then you had your pass to the dance after, And like that, we were all still mad for going dancing at that stage.
But just back to the photograph there, we were talking about Jimmy Connors. Talk. Mm-hmm. I think he was the best man to run and to pick up a ball without being, isn't that right?
With the hurley.
Yeah, with the hurley, at speed. Okay. You know, I haven't seen it, you know what I mean? You don't see it now. But he was, and he had great, fantastic skill.
And then later on, he got a lot of abuse later on.
Terrible abuse.
He'd be fouled and pulled and dragged.
He'd never hit back.
He wouldn't hit back. Yeah. And if he start complaining, the referee give a free against him.
That's right, yeah.
You know, he was abused by the, you know.
I saw Bill on Rakeel one day and he got in trouble with you. He was playing, you know, I was seeing
Huller, Julian Huller.
And he got to Ribble Garden from a good Huller.
Yeah.
But I think they were Pat Fahan that time.
I do.
He ran nearly the length of the field.
Pat Fahan was a guard in Newcastle at the time. He was married to one of the Murphys above him, Bobby. Tim Murphy. He's up in Clare now, up on
Crusheen.
He was from.
Yeah.
Jimmy Stokes.
He was
a fine hurler.
And the same man now at the moment, the last time I did, he's meant to go over to GAA for years. He said he's trying to build it up over Newcastle West GAA. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
But when he went to Limerick then, he was very involved in the PSG.
No, he went first when he went to Limerick, New Orleans that time. No,
yeah.
He was with them and I think he hurled a bit with him.
Jimmy wanted the fine open fast hole. Ball out the wings, completely different, you know. We just said to Paddy, Father Paddy Donovan the other wing, Father Paddy Donovan the other wing was a stronger, more robust player, wasn't he? He could kind of give a fella a dig and shove him all his way, but Jimmy wouldn't do that at all. Jimmy would have to
speed
and go around him. Like.